டாக்டர் டிவி கீதா, ப்ரொஃபஸர், டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் கம்ப்யூட்டர் சயின்ஸ், காலேஜ் ஆஃப் இன்ஜினியரிங், கிண்டி, அண்ணா யூனிவர்சிட்டி. ஹர் ஸ்பெஷல் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் ஆர்டிஃபிஷியல் இன்டெலிஜென்ஸ் அண்ட் நேச்சுரல் லாங்குவேஜ். ஷீ ஹஸ் பப்ளிஷ்ட் மோர் தேன் 143 ஆர்டிகல்ஸ் இன் நேஷனல் அண்ட் இன்டர்நேஷனல் ஜேர்னல்ஸ். ஷீ ஹஸ் கைடட் அரவுண்ட் 7 PhD ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ். She has got Young Scientist Award from Government of Tamil Nadu in the year 2000, Chief Minister's Special Mention Award in the year 2002, and Woman of Excellence by Rotary Club in the year 2003.
Welcome to the UGC lecture series. In this lecture, we are going to go into structured query language. Now, up to this point, we have looked at an introduction of databases, we have looked at what is meant by a relational model, then we have looked at the design, how to design a ER model, design using the ER model, how to map a ER model to relational model or relations. Now, we have got all the relations, the design is over. The next step is we have to create the tables, we have to manipulate the tables, and for this purpose, we are going to talk about the structured query language or SQL as it is called popularly. So, the objectives of this lecture are to understand the basic data definition facilities provided by SQL, how to create and how to drop or how to insert and so on, and how to do querying, and we are only looking at a general structure of SQL querying. We will go, we'll be going into details about this in the next lecture. So, before we go along, what is the history of this language? It was initially called as SQL language, and it was developed as part of the System R project at IBM, and then later on it became was renamed as Structured Query Language or SQL. And basically the SQL consists of two parts, the DDL or the data definition language. Here we try to define and modify the schema or the relation or the table as it is called, and then we have the DML or the data manipulation language, where we write queries in order to get data or insert data or delete data. So, the DBMS is responsible, now the database management system is responsible for precise semantics for the relational queries. So, the relational database model that has they have commercially developed should cater to these things, and you should have an optimizer which can reorder the operations without affecting the actual final answer, and the choices are driven by what is called a cost model. So, basically that is dependent upon the disk accesses and how much of CPU time you use, because as far as database is concerned, as you remember, it talks about large volumes of data which cannot be fully stored in the main memory. So, the disk accesses become a very important cost component. So, basically again SQL is used for the following: data manipulation, data definition, data administration, and all these things can be described using either an SQL statement or command. So, some of the requirements of SQL are: SQL must be embedded in a programming language, fourth generation language like VB, and it is a free form language. So, there is no limit to the number of words per line or fixed line break and so on, and not all versions are case sensitive. Syntax statements, words or phrases are all, but always you write it in lowercase, and keywords are, this is just a convention, are in uppercase. So, basically SQL is a relational database, as we already management system, and it must represent all the information or info in the database as tables. Everything that you do with SQL will be done with, as long as they are in tables, and you are going to keep the logical representation of the data, which is called a schema, which we have already seen, independent, and how it is stored independent from the physical storage characteristics. And you can use one high level language for this SQL, you can be used for structuring, querying and changing information. Everything is uniform, one language you are going to use, which is SQL. So, what are the requirements of an SQL? It has to support the main relational operations like select, project and join. It should have alternate ways of looking at the table. It should have a method for differentiate between nulls, which are unknown values, and nulls. And you have to have additional support mechanism for integrity, authorization, transactions, recovery, all these are part of a relational management system. So, and as we already know, SQL stores all information in the form of tables, and it supports basically three relational operations: select, project and join, and these will be used to manipulate, specify exactly what is the data that you want to display or use. And it, as already said, SQL is used for data manipulation, definition and administration. And so let's first take one by one. Let's first take the data definition language. The data definition language allows the specification of the schema for each relation, including the attribute types, and then it allows integrity constraints to be defined, and it allows authorization information for each relation. So all this is part of the data definition language. And non-standard SQL extension also sometimes allows a set of indices to be maintained for each relation, and physical storage structure of each relation can be specified. This is not the standard of SQL. So let's first take the first command, which is the create table command. So you have designed and kept the relation, you have to design the table. So this is a create table constraint. SQL relation is defined using a create table command. Create table R a1 d1 a2 d2, so on, a n d n, integrity constraint 1, you can have any number. So here R is the relation name or the name of the table. Each AI, this A1, A2 and so on, are the attribute names of that particular attributes of that particular relation R, and DI is the data type, is integer, real or whatever, those data types. So for example, create table branch, branch name character 15, branch city character 30, assets integer. So this is a typical definition of a relation branch which has got three attributes: branch name, branch city and assets, and the type of attribute values are given here. So this is an example database: sailors, boats and reserves. You've seen this example, you must be familiar with this example. So this relation has 4 attributes, this has 3 and this has 3 attributes. You are also defining that this these are foreign attributes of the primary keys of the first 2 relations. Now let's see how to define. Now here we have not done any manipulation, we are just defining the tables. So here is the data definition language with that example. So here you create sailors with 4 attributes: SID, SName, rating and real, and these are the values or type. Now here you are, the new thing that you are studying here is that the primary key is defined as SID. Similarly for boats, you are defining it as BID. Now look at this, this is for reserves. Now reserves has 2 foreign keys. So here you have SID, BID and day, and the primary key is SID, BID and date, and foreign key date or day, and foreign key SID references sailors. Now this is where we are defining something called a foreign key SID, and SID is coming from sailors and this is coming from boats. So those are defined. So here we have learned how to define the primary key and how to define foreign keys. So now let's talk a little bit about the domain types that we have used, these domain types. So characters allowed, you can have a character string of any particular length. Varchar, variable length character strings. Maximum length specified is n. Integer, it's a finite subset of integers. Small int is a machine dependent, it's a subset of domain independent. Numeric, fixed point number with p digits, user specified precision of p digit with n digits to the right of the decimal point. Real time double precision, float n. So these are some of the standard data types provided. Next we look at, remember we said that we can have a create a table and we can also specify the integrity constraints. So you can, for example, you can say not null as an integrity constraint, primary key as an integrity constraint. So example, declare branch name as the primary key for branch. This we have already seen in the previous example. So this example we had branch name character, branch city this, not null, we are specifying this is not null. Branch city cannot be null. Assets, and here we are saying the primary key is branch name for this branch field. Now we have created the table. Now when you are creating the table, it's actually the schema definition. We have not put any tuples into it. So the next step is you have to do insertion and deletion of tuples. So you can so that's what I said, the newly created table is empty. Now I want to add a new tuple to an account relation, let's assume. So insert into this account relation values A9732 Perry Ridge 1200. Now if any of the integrity constraint is violated, this insertion cannot be done. Similarly, suppose you want to delete all tuples from account, then you say delete from account. If you don't specify anything, all the tuples will be deleted. Remember the table still exists. It's not that the table is deleted, only the tuples in the table are deleted. Next you have drop and alter table constructs. The drop table command deletes all information about the dropped relation from the database. All information is removed. The alter table command is used to add attributes. No, you already created a table with some attributes, you want to add some attributes. So what you do here, alter table R add AD. So this attribute A and with that domain type is added, where A is the name of the attribute and D is the domain. Now, all tuples in the relation are assigned null as a value of the new attribute. So, when you are starting off, all the attributes will have a value of null, okay, it is already having tuples means. So, the alter table can also be used to drop attributes. It is not that only you can insert and you can also drop. So, you if you already have an attribute, but you do not want that now, you can drop it. So, again same syntax, A is the attribute and R is the relation from which you want to drop. Dropping of attributes is not supported by many databases implementations. So, now up to now we have seen the data definition language where we have created a table, we have inserted tuples, we have deleted tuples, we have dropped a table, deleted the complete table, we have altered a table by adding attributes or deleting attributes, that much we have seen. Now, let us go into manipulation, data manipulation. So, that is the main challenge of SQL. So, when a user wants to get some information from the database, he has to issue a query. A query is a user request either to retrieve the data and some conditions will be given. So, SQL is a query language that allows user to specify the condition instead of writing at. So, it is a sort of you specify the conditions under which you want the data to be given to you. So, the user specifies a certain condition, the program will go through all the records in the database or tuples in the database and select only those tuples or records which satisfy this condition. So, the result of the query will then be stored in the form of a table. So, the basic structure of a SQL query, we will go into detail of this later. We have a general structure, select all or distinct and then select everything as from where, we will go into detail about this. Comparison operations are all allowed in between likes, percentage, etcetera. Grouping, group by having count, sum, average, max, min, we will come into again detail. And this is the display order, order by ascending, descending. And then we have allow logical operators like AND or NOT. We also allow output, you want into table, to file, to printer, to screen, you also have a union. We will go into these in detail one by one. So, this is the student particular information available. So, here you have a field is ID, it is a type numeric, width is 4, content, this is the student ID number, name, date of birth, sex, class, house code, district code, fee remission and math test score. So, these are the certain types which we and so, this is a big database with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 attributes. Now, let us look at a basic query structure. We are looking at first select operation, okay, select is the easiest one, it is accessing. So, typical SQL query has the form select A1, A2 to AN from R1, R2 to RM where P. So, A1 AI represents an attribute, RI represents a relation and P is a predicate, it is a condition that you are specifying as a predicate. If the predicate evaluates to true, you will release whichever tuples the predicate is satisfied, it will do that, otherwise it will not give you the result. So, the query is equivalent to the relation algebra expression, this which you have already seen, this is the select operation. So, this query is equivalent to the relational algebra expression given above. Now, so the general structure of a select is given this way, select all distinct expression as column expression from table name where condition. So, we will come to these details, select from where is a basic query. So, we will come into detail about this as we go along. So, let us now take a small break. Welcome back after the break. Now, before the break we were talking about the select clause, let us go a little more detail into the select clause, it has got many facilities, let us look at each of the facilities. So, the basic function of a select clause is to list all the attributes desired in the result of the query. So, corresponds to the projection operation of the relational algebra. So, in select we are actually having the select operation as well as the projection operation associated with relational algebra. So, let us assume we have a simple query, find the names of all branches in the loan relation. So, what you will do, you will select branch name, okay, that is the attribute from loan. So, loan is the relation name, this is the attribute name. So, what you are doing is you are selecting only that attribute, so the project. In the relation algebra, this will come as project branch name loan. So, this is the equivalent of that simple query. SQL names are case insensitive. You may have uppercase or lowercase, it does not matter, all these are the same. So, it allows duplicate and relation as a normal course. You can, the query results can have one or more tuples itself, but to force the elimination of the duplicates, you can have a specific provision is given, which is called distinct. So, suppose you want to find the names of all branches in the loan relation, you may have lot of repeated branch names. You want to remove the duplicate, then you say select distinct branch name from loan. This will give you only, there won't be any duplicates in the result. So, the keyword all specify that duplicates are not removed. So, if you write select all branch name from loan, it specifically tells you that all duplicates are not removed. And next is select star from loan. This means all attributes are listed. So, the select clause can contain arithmetic expression involving the operation plus, minus, star anything, and the operating on constants and attributes. Here this just says that all the attributes are listed in the output. So, suppose you say select loan number, branch name, amount star 100 from loan. That is an example where you do that. Now, next we will go to the next part, which is the where clause. Now, the where clause here we did not say any conditions. We just said select all branch name from loan or whatever. So, it just gives all the tuples from that relation, but we do not want all the tuples, we want only some tuples. So, what we do is we go to the next, the where clause. This corresponds to the selection predicate of the relational algebra. So, up to now we have done only the project. So, find all loan number for loans made at the Perry Ridge branch with loan amounts greater than 1200. This is the beauty of the assessing of SQL. Select loan number, this is the project, it takes only one attribute from loan, that is a relation where we are saying branch name is equal to Perry Ridge and amount is greater than 1200, it is better to write it this way. So, this is the predicate, it is an AND, it is connected by an AND and it is a predicate. So, a tuple that satisfies both these conditions only will be taken out. So, this comparison results can be combined using logical connectives such AND or NOT, whatever you want you can use. Next is the from clause. So, we have seen the where clause. Next is the from clause, list the relation involved in the query, correspond to the Cartesian product operation in the relation algebra. So, find the Cartesian product of borrower into loan. So, you have select star from borrower loan. So, this from is from which relation you are going to consider. So, let us take the from clause another example. Find the name, loan number and loan amount of all customers having a loan at the Perry Ridge branch. Now, it gets interesting. How do you tell this? So, select customer name, now customer name, borrower dot loan number, because you are having two relation, you have to write this dot, this is a new format, amount from borrower comma loan, where borrower dot loan number is equal to loan dot loan number, okay. So, loan number and the borrower and branch name is equal to bridge, Perry Ridge. So, find the name, loan number and amount of all customers, okay, having a loan. So, all customers is taken care of because we are taking it from the loan, having a loan at the Perry Ridge branch. So, we are bothered about the loan being at Perry Ridge branch. Remember, the loan relation will have loan and branch and so on, and the borrower relation will have the loan amount. So, this is what he is combining. Now, let us have a summary of the complete SQL query. Remember, it has basically three things, select, from and where. Now, let us look at each of these components in detail. Now, this distinct tells me that it is an optional keyword, just tells me that I do not want the results to have duplicate tuples. This target list is a list of attributes that you want to take out and from the relation list. From, and this relation list is a list of relation names possibly with a range value after each name, and this is the qualification, this has a predicate as we already defined, and it can have comparison comparisons combined using all the Boolean operations like AND, OR and NOT. And comparisons are attribute or it can have an attribute opposite, operator attribute 2 and so on, equal to, less than, everything it can have. So, this is a very very expressive constraint. So, the semantics of SQL query defined in terms of the following conceptual evaluation strategy. How is the query evaluated? So, you compute the cross product of the relation list, discard the resulting tuples if they fail the qualifications or the predicate values, delete attributes that are not in the target list, and if distinct is specified, eliminate tuples. This is a general form, but this strategy will give the worst efficiency. So there are all query systems or relational database systems have optimizers that will give you the same answer at lower cost. We are not going to go into detail of that. So select ra.s.b from r.s, where r.c equal to s.c can be written in this form in its relational algebra format. Now let's look at a example. Select s.s name from sailors s, reserves r. This is the range variable which we did not use in the previous examples, where this is just to specify it more carefully or more specifically. S dot SID equal to R dot SID, both should be same, and R dot BID is equal to 103. Example, this is the example. So this example, just to remind you, so let's look at how the query is evaluated. So here we have taken S name, we need only S name, from sailors dot S, reserves R, where S dot SID equal to R dot SID. So this is the place, and R we are bothered only about 103. So only this will come out, as we will be taking out only rusty, nothing else. All the rest will not come into the picture. So that is if it is not evaluated in a good way. Now really needed only if the same relation appears twice. So we have used range value here, variable that is not always used. It's only used if the same relation comes. So select s dot s, s name from sailors s, reserves R. This is the previous query. Here we do not have to put that, you can put this, but this is a better style. So we have already seen this general structure, this is just giving you more in detail. So distinct will eliminate duplication. So the condition can be all these operators. Okay. Now before you use the SQL, you have to open the student file saying use student, that is the one from which you want to ask the query. List all student records, it will just say select star from student. Remember, star gives all the attributes, and the result will be this. So you have to say use that relation and then do this. So list the names and house code of all 1A students. This is slightly different example. So here I have select name, H code, class from student, where class equal to 1A. So this is the only 1A will be outputted, the rest of it will not come. List the names and house codes of 1A students. So only these will come, okay, only the name and H code attributes will come. List the residential district of the Red House members, select distinct decode from student, where H code is equal to R. So the result will be only the decodes, and remember there may be multiple decodes, but since we have given distinct, only it will be the duplicates will be removed. List the names and ages of 1B girls. So I want 1B girls. So condition for 1B girls is class equal to 1B and sex equal to female, and it has to be connected by an AND operator. So listen, so what is age? Age is based on the date of birth, so it is a derived attribute. Select name, round date, date of birth by 365. Here we are actually do not have the date of birth, age as age. So we are defining this to be as age. So now look at the flexibility that is introduced from student, where class equal to 1B and sex is equal to female. Okay. So we are trying to get an attribute that has been derived, the value of an attribute that has been derived. So the result will be this. So list the names, ID of 1A students with no fee remission. So here, and not remission. So that not operation use is what we have given here. So another one operation or facility given by SQL is the renaming operation. So old name as new name, find the name and loan number and loan amount of all customers and rename the column name loan number as loan ID. So that's given. Select customer name, borrower dot loan number as loan ID. So this is the this as acts as a rename, and the tuple variables are defined in the from clause via the use of the as clause. So borrow as T, loan as S, and you can write that. So select distinct T dot branch name from branch as T, branch as S. So this, instead of using branch dot branch name, you can use it as T dot branch name. This is allowed. So the keyword as is optional. So we have, remember this we use as range values. So that is allowed. Depends on whether it is Oracle or other commercial usages, the syntax will be slightly different. In relations with duplicate, SQL can define how many copies of tuples appear in the result. So multi-set version, some allow more than one value also, that is allowed. So this is the duplicate one in which the how the relational algebra does this. So, if there are C1 copies of tuple T1 in R1 and T1 satisfies the selections, then there are C1 copies normally. So, what you do? You remove the LM duplicates. So, suppose you have a multiset like this, then you will have to remove the duplicates. So, that is equivalent to this operation. So, basically what we have seen here is the basis of database manipulation things. So, now let us look at this duplicate semantics. Select A1, A2 to AN from R1, R2 to RM, where P is equivalent to the multiset version of the, here you have not removed any duplicates. So, what happens? You have, this is the operation A1, A2 to AN, and then you have the this thing where R1, R2, this is the according to the predicate, you are doing a R1, R2, you are taking all the tuples of R1, this is what is explained here. So, suppose you have the relation R1 AB and R2 C, and it is R1 is 1, it is 1A, 2A and R2 is 2, 3, 3. Now, this will give me, this is what we are talking about, it will give me A2 and then you have again A2, then you have A3 and then you have A3 again, then you have A3. So, this is what we get as here, and you understand how the duplicates come. Now, when we want this to be removed, this is the output that you will get. This is talked in terms of relational algebra, this output you will get. So, if you want to remove this, then you use the duplicate. So, you must be careful in what you use the duplicates for. This is the multiset version of that expression. So, what have we spoken about in this lecture? Basically, we have explained how SQL acts as both a data manipulation as well as a querying language. And for data manipulation, we have looked at how to create a table, and if you want to drop the table, what do you do? Then how to insert tuples into, when you do create table, you have an empty table, then how do you insert tuples into the table? Then in case you have already created the table, then you find that you want to add some attributes, then you have alter relation. If you have drop some attributes, that is also allowed. Basically when you are creating a table, you could also talk about defining the primary key, defining the foreign key, those are allowed, and also you can specify integrity constraints, that is, it should not be null or things like that can be specified. So, that is about the data manipulation. Then we went into the second part where we spoke about data definition. Now, we spoke about data manipulation. Here we have looked at only one clause, the select clause. So, select from where, only that we have defined, but we took cases where we had two relation where it becomes interesting. So, in the next lecture we will be talking more in detail about SQL queries. So, here I want you to create a table supplier with the following structure. So, this is a schema creation, and then write queries to list the names of all suppliers whose S code is greater than 5, find all suppliers who have deposit equal to 2000. File all suppliers who have S code equal to 4 and depositor greater than 2000. Explain what exactly these two sub languages of SQL are and what are the components of a basic SQL query. Thank you.